As I see the day approaching, day when Christ will come again, is the question I keep asking of myself and of all men. When he comes, when he comes, when he comes, when he comes, will I be ready when he comes? Have I banished all my sins? Do I have this peace within? Am I ready for the Lord to come? While the signs are clearly showing that our Lord will soon return, oh, I pray these words I'm asking in your quiet heart will burn. When he comes, when he comes, when he comes, when he comes, will you be ready when he comes? Have you banished all your sins? Do you have this peace within? Are you ready for the Lord to come? When he comes, when he comes, when he comes, will you be ready when he comes? Have you banished all your sins? Do you have this peace within? Are you ready for the Lord to
you all this Sabbath evening in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. As we bid farewell to our Sabbath this evening, a story is told of three boys who went to a dumping site. Now, as these three boys went to the dumping site, they were looking for metal. And as they were looking for metal, their sole purpose was to find the metal and sell the metals so that they may be able to make money out of the metals. Now, all of them were or the two of them were going deep looking for these metals, searching for them and moving everything that was in the dumping site just to find the metal. And then there was this one boy who was very intelligent enough to look for a radio. And when he looks for a radio, he looks for the magnet within the radio, which is found normally in the speaker. And the others ask him a question, why do you look for the radio? And he tells them that in a radio there is a magnet, and once I have found the magnet, I am able to wave the magnet around the rubbish, and once I've waved it around the rubbish, then the metals will automatically come and stick to the metal. That way I save myself from getting dirty, and I save myself from going deep into the dumping site or into the rubbish. Now, why am I bringing this story? The book of Matthew chapter 6 verses 33 says, but seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all shall be added unto you. Christ then is the metal. And once we have found Christ as the metal, all as the magnet, all the metals that we are looking for, then will be attracted to the magnet. If we find the magnet, then everything else that we need will be added unto us. Another story is told of a young boy and his father who were rich and were living in America. Now, as they were rich, they would love paintings. Why do they love paintings? It is because they believed in the artistic nature which they find in paintings. And when they believe in this artistic nature that they love, that they find in paintings, they would always buy paintings of expensive artists. They would buy the Mona Lisas, they would buy your Vincent van Goghs and all these other people who would normally paint paintings in canvases. And one day it happened that the son then decided to join the army, as it was important, or as the country needed people who would go and join the battle in Vietnam. And when the son joined the army and enlisted for the army, when he arrived at the army, he met a friend, and he became too close with this friend to an extent whereby, at the time whereby they were at war and they were under attack, the son then saved the life of his friend. Later on in life, when the friend comes back home, he then visits the son's father. And when he arrives there, he arrives with a big board or the big canvas. And he knocks on the door and he says, and he knocks on the door. And when the father opens the door, then he then says to the father, "My father, I know you do not know me, but I am the friend which your son laid his life for. And I do not have anything to bring. But I know that you and your son loved paintings, as he used to tell me about the paintings that you love. As a matter of fact, I have painted a portrait of your son. And this is all that I can give to show thanks or to say thanks to you because of what your son has done for me." Now the father would leave the painting in a special room, of which whenever any guest would come, he would make sure that they pass into that guest room to see the painting of the son. One time then the father got to die, and all his assets has to go to auction. And when he sends his assets to auction, he then makes the first thing to be sold the painting of the son. The auctioneer then begins with the auction, and he begins to say, "There is the painting of the son." Rich people were there, people who wanted the assets of this old man were there. And they all wanted all the expensive paintings that he had. They all wanted all the expensive wealth that he had, but they did not want the painting of the son. And then the auctioneer started to say, the auction sale begins with the painting of the son. If one gets to buy the painting of the son, then we'll be able to move to other things. And then everyone did not want to buy the painting of the son. And then one person behind the auction hall then decided to raise his hand, and he says, "I pledge $10 to the painting of the son." Now everyone was saying, it is only him who wants the painting of the son. Let us get over and done with the painting and then move on to serious stuff. Then the auctioneer said, "Going once, going twice," sold to the man at the back. Now only to find out that the man at the back was the gardener who used to work in the house of the father. And it happens that the auctioneer then, after selling that painting, gets to pack up everything, and he then gets to end the auction. Now people were asking a question, "Why are you finishing the auction? Where are you going? We still have to buy other assets of the father." Then the auctioneer said, "There was a stipulation in the will that I was not supposed to make. The stipulation then said that whoever buys the painting of the son then gets to get everything that is remaining of the father." Now everyone missed out on an opportunity to receive everything else by not buying the painting of the son. Now the Bible says, "Seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all shall be added unto you." Hebrews chapter 11 verse 6 says that, "But without faith it is impossible to please God. For he who comes to him must believe that he is, and that he is, and he rewards those who diligently seek him." Now it is my prayer today that we remember that we should always seek for God. How do we seek for God? We seek for God by faith. And for us to be able to get everything that we need to first believe that God is, God exists, God is there. And once we believe that God is there, God will reward those who diligently seek him. A simple way to get all those that which we want, it is to only find that which we need. And that which we need is the magnet. Once we have found the magnet, we are able to attract all the metals. And once we have found Christ, we are able to attract everything that which we need and everything that which we want. It is my prayer that as we enter into this new week, we remember that once we have found Christ, all things will be added unto us. May the Lord bless us all. In Jesus' name we do pray. Amen.